you guys. All right, fantastic. Let me start with swine flu. I'd like to announce that the government has agreed in principle to offer frontline health staff and emergency personnel vaccination against swine flu. The Ministry of Health has ordered an initial supply of 300,000 doses, enough to vaccinate 150,000 people, of a vaccine from Baxter's Healthcare under one of its two existing agreements for pandemic influenza vaccine. Having the vaccine is primarily an insurance policy. We want to be in a position to have the vaccine and not need it, rather than the other way around. Global demand for vaccines is obviously very high, so we have secured sufficient vaccine for this priority group of New Zealanders. In addition, we have a long-standing option to access more vaccine if required. The vaccine is due for delivery within 1 month, but it will not be used for an immunisation program unless it is licensed as safe and effective to use by Medisafe. A licensing decision is expected by the end of this year. The pandemic could last up to 18 months to 2 years, so the purchase is strategic in nature. Currently, the new pandemic influenza virus was resulting in a mild illness for most people. So vaccination is an important tool, but not the only tool in the country's armoury against this new virus. I'd like to repeat the public health messages. Tried and proven hygiene measures are our first line of defence through frequent and thorough hand washing and drying, covering coughs and sneezes, and staying away from other people if you're sick. At this stage, there are no plans to launch a mass vaccination program, as the nature of the illness does not warrant it. But we expect this virus will change over time, so we're keeping our options open. At this point, I'd like to pass over to the Minister of Health to make some comments and answer some questions. Once we've finished any questions you have in relation to swine flu, then we can move on to the rest of the items on the press conference.
Thank you, Prime Minister. The latest information from the Ministry of Health is that our total in the country today is 1,059 confirmed swine flu cases, which is the tip of the iceberg, as we're now doing comparatively limited testing to previously. Just an update on a couple of the cases. The young Wellington 17-year-old admitted to Wellington Hospital ICU on Friday with swine flu and no underlying medical conditions. She's now been upgraded from a critical condition to serious but stable. And the family of the Christchurch man who died last Thursday from suspected swine flu has asked the Canterbury District Health Board to release a statement which says that they are deeply saddened by the death of their son and father, who has been unwell for some time with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which is a lung disease, before he died with the flu. He was 42 years old and died at home. We're a very private family and do not wish to make any further details for release about him, and that they have specifically asked for that. Thank you. Any questions?
Can I just double check this vaccine that you've bought, it hasn't been licensed by MedSafe yet, but it will still be made available to medical staff?
No, it won't be made available until it's licensed. There is no vaccination for swine flu anywhere in the world that is currently licensed. But what we've done is taken public health officials' recommendation to get the strategic stock in place for once it is licensed, expected to be by December, and then in light of circumstances at that time, it would be our plan to make that available to frontline health and public service staff if they wanted it.
So when would be the earliest that you would be visited?
Well, I think the earliest this would happen would be December.
Well, isn't that likely to be well after the swine flu peak?
We don't know exactly when the swine flu peak will be, but what we do know is this pandemic could be with us for 18 months to 2 years. And what the public health officials have recommended is taking this action, because this would help, or could help, prevent illness in some of the key staff that we have in our health and emergency services. What we know is that there's going to be a lot of pressure on hospital emergency departments, GP clinics, up and down the country during the winter flu season, as it is always, but also with swine flu. And anything that we could do that might help prevent some of those frontline workers getting ill and having to take time off home should be supported. But as I said, this vaccine, which will be in the country within the next month, will not be licensed until probably December, and it is then that we'd make it available.
Is it being used anywhere in the world?
No, it's not being used anywhere else in the world at the moment, but it is going to be tested in Europe, and that information will help inform regulatory agencies around the world. Now, MedSafe and the Ministry of Health are in constant touch with these other agencies, and once it is in a position to be licensed, then we can license it.
What's the cost of it?
The cost is commercially sensitive. It's some millions of dollars, but we're not able to give you that figure.
So is there no way that they can speed up the licensing of this? Do they do their own tests?
Licensing is a lengthy process. And all the information that we have is that we won't get a license of a vaccine anywhere in the world until much closer to December.
It seems like an unusual number, far too few for the general population, far too many for frontline health.
Well, it's frontline health. We've got a list here because this is as per the plan, the pandemic plan, and we'll be giving you this list with the media release, but it includes health staff, police, corrections, key fire service staff, etc. So it is a large number of frontline services, and its purpose is, as a strategic purpose, is to enable those people to stay well longer because of their critical services that they provide.
When we're talking about vaccinations,
well, that would be if you were going to have a national campaign. Officials have not recommended a national campaign because they consider that this virus is mild for most people who get it. What they have recommended is the strategic purpose to support frontline agencies once it's licensed.
Minister, is this the cell culture as opposed to egg vaccine?
That's correct.
And has New Zealand ever purchased this kind of vaccine before?
Not to my knowledge, but this new cell technology is relatively new, though has been used around Europe. We normally get our supply from CSL in Australia, which is an egg-based culture.
Can it really be commercially sensitive when you're spending public money?
Well, these arrangements are always commercially sensitive in this sort of arrangement, but we're satisfied that we've got a good deal for New Zealand.
Minister, it seems that asthmatics seem to be susceptible to swine flu, largely at the moment. Are you doing anything for them, or is there any sort of special treatment that they might get in the future?
Public health officials haven't recommended any vaccination campaign for those who, for example, may have chronic diseases. On the specific mention of asthmatics, very clear message going from experts up and down the country is that asthmatics should continue to use their preventers as much as possible as a way of keeping them healthy. Well, it is potentially possible that if matters escalated dramatically, then with informed consent, people could get access to such a vaccine. But I have to say that's not a possibility that we're entertaining at this stage.
You've got a list here of 142,000 odd people and 300,000 doses. Is it a double dose vaccine?
Yes, that's correct. You get two doses.
Cabinet ministers?
Definitely not.
Are they not essential services?
No, we're not frontline health or public emergency service frontline workers.
Is it your advice that any more people are likely to die of the flu this year than any other year?
Well, we lose about 435 New Zealanders a year to seasonal flu. And it's my advice, and as we've been saying all along, that because there are going to be more people with flu this winter, there will be more lives lost.
Mr. Ryall, the Chief Coroner announced
the Chief Coroner confirmed the two cases of people who passed away at home, and Wellington Hospital confirmed the case of the young girl who died in hospital. And that will continue to be the format. If people pass away in hospital, it'll be announced by the District Health Board. If they pass away at home and the coroner draws a conclusion of a link to swine flu, then he will make that announcement, but we will be able to relay that to you in our daily update.
There's some precautions for the Prime Minister's trip this week, regarding people not having certain temperatures before they get on the plane. Are we concerned about the spread to the islands from New Zealand? Because obviously a lot of people travel to and from there.
Well, we're concerned about the spread anywhere, but the messages remain the same. If people should, if they are sick, stay at home, because one way we can stop this spreading further in the community more faster than it is if people take responsibility and stay at home if they're unwell.
But if there was a spread to places like, say, Samoa or Tonga, would we have to help contain or help with the responses there? Would that be...
Well, I think New Zealand is in constant touch with the Pacific Islands, and we've been providing them with advice and support, is the information that I've got.
Do we know if it's running out on those islands?
I'm not in a position to give you that information, but the Ministry could.
Has this new vaccine been through any clinical trials at all yet?
Those trials are going underway as we speak, and of course that will be part of the licensing process.
Prime Minister, will you get a vaccine?
No, not on the list.
Okay.